I wish that you prosper and be in health even as your soul prospers. God is the master and giver of success. Success is what defines who he is and what he does. His creative works are wonderful and amazing to behold. You cannot be connected to him and end up failing. You cannot follow his leading or ways and end up in disgrace. It is only by him that true success is achieved and attained. His promises are for you to be outstanding and to be a success. It doesn't matter where you are now. It does not matter how long you have been a failure. He can turn things around and you would be on the success side again. Everything might have been difficult. Things may seem to be going the wrong way. Maybe you have walked your way into depression and pains. It is not going to end that way. He promised to be with us to the end of the ages. Probably you feel weak or unable to carry on. You need to depend on God because with him, you cannot fail. When Joshua was about to continue from where Moses stopped, he felt as though he cannot be in the shoes of Moses, but God told him to be strong and be courageous, and he would lead them through. It is time for you to hold God firm, even as things in the world seem to be going the other way round. It is time to comfort yourself with the promises of God which cannot fail. Failure is not found in him. God's charge to us today is to be strong and courageous. Not be afraid or tremble in dread before them. For he who goes with you, he will not fail you or abandon you. I do not know what are your dreams, hopes, and ambitions. You need to surrender and walk with him. He cannot fail, and you would not fail with him. You need to trust the one who knows your end from the beginning. He does not know what it means to fail, even if all other things fail. His word and promises cannot fail. What is before you now, what lies tomorrow, only he knows all that. And you must have faith and trust him. This is what Abraham did. He never knew the future or what he held or what awaited him, but he decided to follow someone that knows what and how tomorrow is. He decided to trust the leading of God and kept following and working with him even when it was like the promise was taking longer than expected. He never doubted or stopped believing and following, and he was made a great man. Trust him. Give him your hopes and aspirations, your wants and dreams, your doubts and worries, your fears and anxieties. Put those in his hands and turn your focus on sharing his joy, love, and peace with a world that is hurting and desperate for hope. Joshua was one man that had trust in the promises and leading of God. He stepped in and took over from a great man and was afraid, but God promised to lead him, see them through, and give them success. In the last verse of Joshua 21, he affirmed that by saying, "Not one of the good promises which the Lord had spoken to the house of Israel failed. All had come to pass." Can you see that? There was no failure because they rode with God. God is almighty. He is trustworthy. What God says, he will do. He will do. The secret of success and sustained success and victory lies in the promises of God. You need to know his promises and hold to them. Joshua 1 verse 8 says, "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall read and meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything in accordance with all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will be successful. Your success is in the hands of God, and for you to succeed, you must learn to meditate. Hear His voice and follow His leading. Most times we go astray, walk away from God, and move in the part we think is right, which is not. And then we fail or see things working in the opposite of what we expected, and still tend to ask, "Why, Lord? Why will this happen to me? Why me? Why now? Why, Lord?" But know this, if you are in the Lord and you see things moving the way you did not expect, pray and call upon the name of the Lord. For all these things happens for a reason, because He said it in the book of Romans 8, verse 28. Everything happens for the good of those who love God. So we should not dwell in it. We should not lose hope, start the blame game, or think of changing ways. Doing it by yourself, in your way, without hearing from God, because it's dangerous. He is your shield, and if you walk out of Him, you will not stand a day in the battle of life. So when God is doing things in your life, you should be focused and careful not to fall away, because sometimes it might sound stupid to you and foolish to the ears of men, and then you give up and start it your way. It gives birth to failure, and then you blame it on God. For in the book of Jeremiah 29, verse 11, He said He knows the plans He has for us, plans of good and not of evil, plan to give us hope and an expected end. Did you get that? To give you hope and an expected end. There is no failure in Jesus Christ. God will not let us drown, fail, or be consumed by the evil of this world. He is not a man that He should lie. He promised us an expected end, a great future, and He will see to that. Another instance happened. In the Bible, we all know about Esther. In Esther 4, 5, and 7, when her people were to be killed because of Haman's evil plan, she knew the danger in going to see the king without being asked to. She knew it will cost her life, but she prayed and fasted for 3 days, saying, "I will go see the king. If I perish, I perish." She handed it to God and her total hope of Him. What happened next? Did God not grant her favor in the sight of the king? Did her plans fail? No, God helped her, and because of that act, she saved a whole race from death. Also, in the life of David, a little shepherd, and Goliath, a trained warrior from his youth. 1 Samuel 17, verse 1 through 58. Goliath challenged the Israelites. David, who just bought food for his brothers, heard this, and he could not stand it. In a natural sense, David could have been fed to the birds of the air, but because he fought for the right cause with faith in Christ, he won. He defeated Goliath. He did the impossible, unimaginable, and unbelievable in the eyes of men. Look also at Nehemiah and the other men. When rebuilding the city walls, Nehemiah 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Though challenges came, obstacles stood in their way, they never gave up. They continued to work each day with faith in Christ Jesus. And at the end of it, God helped them. Victory was theirs and the walls were completed. What are you facing? What are you going through? No friends around, fighting for the right cause, and there is no one or shoulder to lean on and cry on. Or could it be that your trust in Him is gone, and you have lost even that faith you had in Him, that He could do everything He said? Why not look to the Lord again? Why not give Him your best this time? Remember, he said to do the things of the kingdom first, and every other thing will be added to you. Why not taste again and see that the Lord is good and will not allow you to fail? When you are dealing with God, just put your trust, faith, and belief in him and see that he will never fail you. When working with God, place it all at his feet through prayer. Do what is needed. Keep holding, never give up, have faith and belief. Watch out so you would not miss the signs and the appointed time for your success or victory. In your walk with God, you must know that he is God. He cannot fail. He never sleeps nor slumbers. He has a good plan for you. He will not let you fail. He gives and releases grace for every assignment he gives, because his grace is sufficient for all of us. Your help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. God never fails. He has promised to be with you and make you the head in everything. Trust him all the way. Walk through each day with the assurance that you are with him and he is leading you, and therefore you cannot fail. Do not give up now. Take the commandment he gave Joshua. Always hear his voice and take his leadings. You would surely succeed.